advertising over long periods of time, and those things are very much in jeopardy at this point. As a matter of fact, they're basically worthless or useless. And the automobile industry, basically you could just today, knowing what you know from here, you can write the total American automobile industry off, because the people that come with the electric cars based on this system will totally wipe out the others. And it's not an American company that's going to do it, because the American companies, the attitude of the people that they have to talk to, with the people like General Motors and others, they look down their nose at you to begin with. And secondly, they have huge staffs of people who are highly competent, and they depend on them to supply them with what they need, and someone from the outside is not about to upset that balance. So there's no way on earth that I could talk to directly with an American automobile company, but I can tell you at this point they are dead and they don't know it. Yes?
If you were given the opportunity to sell it to an American company, would you?
Say again?
If you were given the opportunity to sell it to an American company, would you?
Would not be my first choice. And at this point, I can be very choosy.
Why not?
Basically, because I don't like the attitude. If their attitude was constructive, I would be all for it, but the attitude is destructive. Yes, sir.
Could we have you come up to the microphone and get your questions on, so when you buy the tape, we'll have the questions on as well?
Don, you mentioned that the battery itself was a 6 amp-hour battery.
Yeah, it's a
inside
cadmium
the,
sulfide.
The cad, okay. After doing a calculation with the 40-watt light bulbs, it would have to burn a little over 10 minutes in order to fully exhaust the capacity of a 6-amp battery.
No.
That's according to the 6 amp-hours. Okay, 400 watts. But it's recharging. We know
I have ran these things for several days at a time, and they didn't dim.
Yes, so okay. My question is just to show the audience that, in fact, it isn't working the way you're supposed to.
At this point, I'm not going to get caught up in any debate or argument. What you see is what you see, and if you're uncomfortable with it, well, I'm going to leave you that way.
No, that's all right. Is it possible to change the bulbs to the 100-watt bulbs?
I have some higher-powered bulbs here.
If
you looked at these close, you notice that the filaments were burning out very fast.
Yes.
Matter of fact, those bulbs would be gone probably before we ran another 10 minutes.
Right. The 100-watt bulbs only have to go a little over 4 minutes to exhaust the battery. And if it ran over 4 minutes, there's no question.
Mm-hmm. We'll do that another day. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Other questions?
Do you plan to energize the unit that's laying on the floor?
I did not bring the proper cables to turn it on. I have had it running, and it works just fine.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
When people come to visit me, they get a much better show whenever you start bringing things out in the back of an automobile, and you have very limited space, and you have a problem bringing things for people to see. I have all the amp meters and everything else to prove my point. But I was thinking that I would be able to use this thing, but apparently not. Yes, sir.
How would this be a one-time purchase type deal, or would the people be charged a monthly service for having the device, or how would that work?
Basically, I leave that up to the people that are dealing. The basic structure on a deal on this type of thing would be a joint venture. And there would be the capital to operate it would be 50%, and the technology is 50%. And the policies, the joint venture, I'm the chief executive of it, and also some of the other positions. And then I have people from the other side, the money side, who are in the command structure. And it's kind of like a round table. They decide in what manner and method which it will be marketed. And in most cases, there have been no problems at this point.
What do you see as a purchase deal? Do you see it as being sold outright, or do you see it being leased, or putting a meter on it, or
purchasing, for example, outright and owning it?
Yeah, exactly.
The best deal there is for you to build your own.
Yeah.
You do it with my blessings completely, and if you use some of the schematics which I have, you can do it. There are a number of people that have done it.
You know, this device here on the floor is the same as in the suitcase, but the one in the suitcase is just downsized?
Say again, please?
The device on the floor is the same one in the suitcase, but the one in the suitcase is just downsized?
It's 1/4 scale of this.
So that, how much would that put out? How much?
Actually, it will put out more than the components there can handle. The weak spot would be the capacitors. And the capacitors, the way they're set up, will handle up to about 8,000 volts at about 10 amps.
Okay, your normal household is a 200 amp service. Do you see it
operating
something?
You've got a 200 amp circuit, but the 200 amp circuit is your main. In most houses,
that's with everything.
In our house, it's 500 amp service, but in most houses, 200 amp service would be for the whole house, and that's divided up between 20 and 30 and 40 and 50 amp, and maybe 50 amps about the biggest fuse that's in there.
So a device like that would have to be built bigger to run everything at once?
It depends on how you hook it in.
Okay.
But the fact that I'm even letting you see these things at all is violating my own personal relationship with people who have large investments in this. So the fact that you're able to see the things as they are, consider that my gift to you.
Surely appreciate that.
And it should be enough to get you started on what you want to do. That's the idea behind it. And there are other people in the audience out here who have actually tried to build these things, and there are some that have succeeded, but out of several hundred people I know that have tried it, there's only about 6 that have actually completely succeeded. So why that happens, I don't know. Why it happens, there's really nothing that complicated. Yes, sir.
Do you have an incorporated company of any kind?
Yes.
Is there stock?
I have calling cards and contacts with the International Banking Group that I work with. Early on in this thing, I had made a lot of presentations, and there were all kinds of people running at me and telling me what all kinds of great things they were going to do for me. And the first few tries, it turned out when you got to the table and the money part wasn't there. And those were American people. And same time that was going on, I had a lot of government officials from Japan and Indonesia and from Philippines and from Holland.
Have you issued stock in that company?
Sir?
Have you issued stock in that company?
My ears are playing a trick.
I see. Have you issued stock in that company?
No, there's no stock. The way it's standard operating procedure now, it's non-negotiable. It's 50% for technology, 50% for the money source. I'm the CEO of the whole and the chairman of the whole group. And then the structure comes in underneath that, 8 board members, 4 of which I name. And it's a joint venture company, and the funding is in negotiable funds in the bank.